umbels inflorescence. So this was the main character of morphology, which indicate the morphological characters of the plant boerhavia diffusa. Okay, now we will go on the next slide, that is secondary growth. Secondary growth, what is secondary growth? What is the definition of secondary growth? It is clearly told by the madam, Kinnari madam. So it is not necessary, but although again just like a repetition, that is you can see this is the definition. If you want, you can note down the definition. The increase in thickness due to the formation of secondary tissue. Secondary tissue, that is secondary phloem and secondary xylem. By the activity of cambium and cork cambium is called secondary growth. So this is the complete definition of secondary growth. Clear? Now the diagram shows the TS of boerhavia stem showing the secondary growth. Just diagrammatic figure is here. So the outermost layer you can see, that is epidermis. All the layers you can understand. Then second layer, that is collenchymatous hypodermis. Hypodermis just located just beneath the epidermis. Hypodermis having 3 to 5 layers and all the cells are collenchymatous. Collenchymatous means stool conch. Then third layer, that is cortex. Next to cortex, single layer endodermis is present. Endodermis is followed by pericycle and the intercentral region, that is called pith region. And in boerhavia, the pith region having 3 different types of vascular bundle: outer ring, middle ring and inner ring. Okay, so among the 3 vascular bundle ring, the middle ring and the inner ring, they are known as medullary ring because they are lies towards the pith. That's why they are known as medullary vascular bundle. Okay, now the next type. Okay, friends, this is the diagram. You can see clear the TS of boerhavia stem showing the starting of secondary growth. This is just the starting of secondary growth. So first of all, about the features, main features. So and sauthi upar no layer, that is the outermost layer, is called epidermis. Adhistar ke jane kahi sakai. It is a single layer and this epidermis is totally covered by cuticle. Then epidermis, next layer is cortex. Here cortex is differentiated in 2 region, outer region and inner region. Among the 2 region, outer region is formed this second most layer, that is hypodermis. And the hypodermis layer, they are made up of collenchymatous cells, and it is made up of 3 to 5 layers. Then after the outer layer, the second most layer, that is the cortex, it is made up of parenchymatous cells, mrudutak kosh. So this was about the cortex. That means cortex is many layers, 3 to 5 layers followed by the collenchyma and 5 to 6 layer followed by the parenchyma cell. Then after the cortex, endodermis is present. Endodermis is also known as the innermost layer of the cortex. Suppose this was the cortex layer, and then the innermost layer of the cortex is called endodermis. And endodermis is single layer. The cells are rectangle in shape somewhat, and they have the thicker cell wall. Then after the endodermis, you can see the single pericycle is there, single layer pericycle. But in this diagram, you can see that pericycle is not clear. It become indistinct. Although in normal stem, you can see that this pericycle is made up of, this is the region, the arrow shows endodermis, and just below the endodermis, sclerenchymatous cells patches, pericycle is present in the sclerenchymatous patches like this. The arrows indicate the position of sclerenchyma cells. Okay, then after the pith region having 3 different rings of vascular bundle. This one is the outer ring, this one is the middle ring and the inner ring. Okay, now among that, the outer ring having the number of vascular bundle. This is the 1 vascular bundle, 2nd and 3rd, because this is just a small segment of the stem. And here the secondary phloem, you can see the arrow shows the secondary phloem. It is not found continuous, but the secondary phloem due to the secondary growth, because the stem, because the diagram showing the starting of secondary growth. So here the secondary phloem is found in the form of crust patches, and later on the secondary phloem, they also form the complete ring. Then about the vascular bundle, all the vascular bundle, they are conjoint, collateral and open type. Conjoint, collateral, it is goodly explained by the madam, and open, that is in which vascular bundle cambium is present, they are known as open, while the cambium is absent, they are known as closed. So this was about the vascular bundle. Then between the vascular bundle, you can see the thick walled cells are there. And this region, the arrow shows that this region is called conjunctive tissue. And all the conjunctive tissue, the cells are sclerenchymatous, having the very thick cell, and they are dead cell. Okay. Then this was about the outermost ring. Now about the middle ring. Middle ring consisting 6 to 15 vascular bundles are there. Like as the outer ring, this bundle also, they are conjoint, collateral and open. This bundle having the intrafascicular cambium. Intra and inter, that is the difference, is very clear in your mind. Okay. So this type of bundles, they are also known as medullary vascular bundle, because the middle ring and the inner ring, they are present in the pith region. That's why they are known as medullary vascular bundle. So these type of bundle, they produce small amount of secondary tissue. Secondary tissue, that is secondary phloem towards the outside and secondary xylem towards the inside. Now about the inner ring. Inner ring have just two large sized vascular bundle. Among them, one you can see clear. This bundle is also very clear, and it is again conjoint, collateral and open type. But comparison to the middle, the inner bundles, they are very large in size, and they are, both the bundles, they are facing towards each other, and they also produce very small amount of secondary xylem and secondary phloem. So this was about the features, anatomical features of the boerhavia stem, showing just the starting of secondary growth. Now, so these are the points which we have
discussed.
Okay, now these are some slides which are related with the abnormal secondary growth, that is Rayleigh secondary xylem with vessels and fiber. In figure you can see clear that the xylem is present with vessels and fiber. Next slide. The arrow, blue color arrow, shows newly formed outermost cambium ring. Because the boerhavia stem, the abnormal secondary growth in boerhavia diffusa is only and only due to the formation of extra cambium ring. So the arrow shows cambial rings, which is recently developed xylem. Okay. Next slide. Yes. Here number of growth rings are present. Growth ring, that is, they are present due to the activity of extra cambium rings. This is the first ring, second, third, fourth, etc., etc. So the growth rings, that means the second anomalous secondary growth. It is clearly indicated by the diagram. Now about the transverse section of TS of stem boerhavia. That means the formation of second cambium ring. This one is the second cambium ring, and this one is the first cambium ring. So the second cambium ring is just formed outside of the first cambium ring. Okay. Now what is abnormal secondary growth? It having several three points. Among them, number one, that is presence of secondary phloem and secondary xylem. You can see clear secondary phloem and secondary xylem. Second topic, that is presence of three rings of vascular bundle. Number one, two and three. Three rings are very clear in the diagram, outer, middle and inner. Then the third point is presence of two medullary vascular bundles. So among the three rings, that is first ring, second ring and third ring, the middle ring and the inner ring, they are known as medullary bundles, because the reason is very clear in your mind that they are present inside the teeth region. That's why they are known as medullary vascular bundle. Okay. Now about the activity of cambium. What is the activity which will be done by cambium and due to which the secondary growth is possible? So the secondary growth consisting two main points, that is number one, medullary rings, and second, that is abnormal growth. So medullary bundles, out of three, two bundles, they are known as medullary bundles, and these medullary bundles, they develop some amount of secondary tissue. Okay, then now about the special thing, that is on due to which the secondary growth, that is the anomalous abnormal secondary growth, will depend, that is the outer ring. It totally depends on outer ring. Okay, now we are focusing on the outermost ring. So the outermost ring of the boerhavia diffusa, you can see number of vascular bundles are there. Each vascular bundle is again conjoint, collateral and open type. Open, that is cambium is present, but in this vascular bundle the cambium is present, which is intrafascicular cambium. Okay, so each bundle having intrafascicular cambium. Now the between two bundle interfascicular cambium is also developed. So later on what happen, the intrafascicular cambium and interfascicular cambium both connect with each other and forming the complete cambial ring, and that is the main point of secondary abnormal secondary growth in boerhavia diffusa. So later on what happen, so the first cambium ring, this is, it is formed. That means the cambial, first cambial ring is equal to the connection between intracambial ring, intrafascicular cambium ring and interfascicular cambium ring. And soon after, the first cambial ring become functionalless. That means in a very short time it stop its functions. So that what happen, after some time the cells, parenchyma cells, they are producing the cambial, new cambial ring towards the region of pericycle, that means towards the endodermis, in short towards the outside. So now what happen, the newly formed, that is the second cambial ring, again develop secondary tissue towards the, sorry, secondary phloem towards outside and secondary xylem towards inside. And again after some time the second cambial ring, that is the new cambial ring, again it become functionalless. And then after, the new cambial ring is developed. Thus this process will be repeated, and ultimately the process is resulted in the formation of numerous cambial rings. And these cambial rings, they are developing successively secondary phloem and secondary xylem. So in the transverse section you can see numerous secondary growth rings. Growth rings, they are alternating secondary xylem and secondary phloem. Okay, now about the parenchyma cells, what is the activity of cambium? So the cambium cell become, when the first cambial ring, then the parenchyma cell become activate and they are converted into the cambial ring. Thus more and more cambial rings are developed, and more cambial rings developing more and more secondary tissue, and this process ultimately result into the thickness of the stem. That is the main character of the anomalous secondary growth in boerhavia diffusa. Okay, now the conjunctive cell, conjunctive tissue is between, present between the two vascular bundle, and conjunctive tissue is nothing but it is the conversion of fiber. So several parenchyma cell become meristematic and they produce vessels and fibers. Vessels towards the intrafascicular region and the fibers towards the interfascicular cambium. So later on the interfascicular cambium fiber, they are converted into very hard tissue, and the hard tissue is made up of sclerenchyma cells. And sclerenchyma cell, they possess very thick cell wall, because they have the lignin and cellulose. So the main function of the collenchyma cells, that is the conjunctive tissue, is just mechanical. It provide the mechanical support to the plant body. Okay, now we go on the next slide. So this is the last slide, that is the comparison between starting of secondary growth and the second slide. You can see that the formation of secondary second cambium ring. That is the secondary, normal secondary growth, and this was is the abnormal secondary growth. The difference is clear in your mind, that you can see that here cambium and cork cambium is absent, while here you can see the outermost layer, that is cork, and just inner cork cambium is present. Cork cambium and cambium, it is very clear. So it made a, and next to it secondary cortex is present. Here cortex is only one type, and here cortex is present also in two types, that is primary cortex and secondary cortex. Three bundles are also there, and here you can see in second diagram the first cambium ring and second cambium ring. That is the significance of the abnormal secondary growth of boerhavia diffusa. So in short, the secondary abnormal secondary growth in boerhavia diffusa is totally depends due to the formation of excessive cambial rings. Okay, clear? That is the difference between normal and abnormal stem. Okay, now the next topic, that is the
next slide.
And now the anomalous secondary growth in Leptodania stem will be discussed by the Mittal madam. Okay, thank you.
Anomalous secondary growth in Leptodania stem. Leptodania is a dicotyledon plant. We have to learn the anomalous secondary growth with the help of transverse section of the stem. This is the transverse section of the Leptodania stem. Look here. Outermost layer is known as the epidermis. Then after hypodermis, this is chlorenchymatous cortex, this is endodermis, this is pericycle, secondary phloem, secondary xylem, medullary ray, included phloem, protoxylem, internal phloem, and the last layer of the stem is peat. Epidermis. The outermost layer is known as epidermis. Epidermis consists of a single layer of thin wall cells. They are compactly arranged and they